Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS project. So today we are going to see one more real-time project. So here we have a Excel workbook, and that workbook contains multiple Excel sheets. So first we need to read the data from all those Excel sheets and loading that data into the SQL Server tables. But here we have a catch, like according to the sheet names we need to move the data. So directly we are not going to move the data. In the last project we have seen how we can directly read the data from all the Excel sheets and loading that into the SQL Server tables. But here according to the sheet name we need to move the data. So go to on the next slide and try to understand about the project in depth. So here, like, first we need to use the loop that is available in the blue color. So in between, like, first we need to get the sheet name. And here we need to check the sheet name. So in the source we are having two different types of data sets. First is customer data set and second is address data set. So inside the customer data set, if the sheet name which is gonna start with the customer will be going to on the right side arrow you could see, and in case of the address that will be going in the downside arrow. So according to the sheet we need to configure that data flow task where we can load the data into SQL Server table for the customer sheet, and for the address sheet. Now go to on the Excel source and have a quick look of the source. So this is our source. As you could see, we are having the addresses. So address for US, address for Canada, address for Australia, address for other countries. And similarly, we have the data for the customer US, then customer Australia and customer Canada and customer others. So we need to loop through on all these Excel files and load that data into the SQL Server tables according to the sheet name. Now go to on the destination and we'll look about the SQL Server tables. So here basically we have three different tables. First table which is country table, second is the address table, and last is the customer table. So in case of the customer table, so we can directly load the data from the source to destination because here we have customer ID, then title, first name, middle name, last name, suffix, account number, store ID and address ID. If you go in the source, then go to on the customer sheet, we can see we have the customer ID, title, first name, middle name, last name, suffix, account number, store ID and address ID. So this data can be directly dumped into the SQL Server table. Now go to on the address and country table. So in the address table we have address ID, address line 1, line 2, city, postal code and country ID. And this country ID is available on the country table. So we can map with the country ID. So in the source we don't have the country ID. If we go in the address, so here we could see we have the address ID, line 1, line 2, city, postal code, but here we have the country name. So first we need to load the data which is available in the country name into the country table, and after that we need to do the lookup on the country name to get the country ID. And this country ID is the identity column, so it will be going to incremented one by one as you can also check. So here if you go and you can see the identity, so customer ID is the identity and it is going to start with the 1 and incremented value, that is again 1. So this is our requirement and we need to design the package accordingly. So go to on the SSDT and where we'll try to create the package. So this is our blank SSDT file. So first of all, as I told you, we need to use the for each loop container to loop through all the Excel files. So here we need to use this for each loop container. So we can drag and drop it here. Let me try to make it bigger size like this and double click on that. Now go to on the collections, and inside the collections we have enumerator. So as we have already seen in the last video, so we can use the for each ADO.NET schema row set enumerator. Then it is asking for the connection. So connection, you can see we have this file, so we can copy the path and click on the new connection, And here I have already made the connection, so let me delete that and click on new. Here we can see the provider. So .NET provider, Access Database, OLADB provider. If it is not available on your machine, then I have explained in the last video, you need to download a driver for the same and need to install on your machine. Now click on OK. Here it is asking for the server or file name, so we can paste that path. Now go to the all, and in the top side inside the advanced we have the extended property. So in the extended property it should be Excel 8.0 that you can specify like this. Now we can test the connection. So test connection succeed. So it looks good. Click on OK. Again OK. Now inside the schema we need to loop through on the tables, that is seats. Click on the set restrictions. So we want to get the table name. So table name is coming on the third position. It means 0, 1, 2. So index 2 is containing table name. Now we can go on the variable mapping. And here we need to create a variable. So we can click on this and click on new variable. And we can call this variable as seat name and click on OK. In the index it should be 2 as you have already seen. Now click on OK. Now we need to check whether this for each loop container is going to loop through with all the Excel seats or not. So for the same we need to use the script task. So we can drag and drop this script task in the for each loop container. Let me double click on this script task, and here let me select the user seat name variable. Click on the edit script, where we need to write the script to check the values whether that is going to loop through with all the Excel seats or not. So it will take few seconds. Now here we can write the message box dot so, then we can specify DTS dot variables, and within the bracket we can paste the variable name, then the value dot to string. We can save this and we can close that. Click on OK. Now let me try to execute this and we will see whether it is going to loop through with all the Excel sheets or not. So as you can see, address Australia, Canada, others, US, Australia, Canada, others, US. So it looks good. It is going to loop through with all the Excel file. So here we need to create one more variable, and that variable will be going to contain the table name. Table name means here inside the Excel file we have the table name, that is address, then we have dash US, then address dash Canada. So before this dash, that is the table name. So on that particular variable we need to calculate this. Now go to on the SSDT, right click on this, go to on the variables, and let me click on this new variable, and let me call this as seat name new, data type that should be string, and inside the expression we need to write that. So here let me close this. Let me provide a dummy name for this, like customer dash US dollar. So this will be the seat name. Now let me click on the expression and we need to evaluate. So first, like we have the seat name, we can evaluate, and it is having customer dash USA dollar. So here first I am going to use the find string. So find string is a function that is going to use to find any particular character within a text. So first, that is from where we want to search out. Second, what character we want to search, and third variable from where we want to start. Let me click on evaluate expression. So it is saying it is having an error while trying to convert this. to the string. So let me copy this, cancel this, try to change this to integer 32, go back to here, paste that and try to evaluate. So it is going to return 9. So we can start counting like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So on the 9th position we have that. But what we are going to do, first let me try to change this to a string and go back to here. First we need to use the substring function. So inside the substring function, we want to get the text from the seat name, from where it is going to start, that is 1, and second will be this find string. Now we can evaluate. So it is going to return customer dash. That is okay. We can click on okay and we can save that. So on the basis of that particular variable, we need to go on the address or customer table. So we need to drag and drop two data flow tasks, one for the customer and second for the address. So let me configure for the customer first. So here we have the customer. We can connect from this script task. Let me double click on this. And in the evaluation operation, we need to use the expression and constant both. While we have this success on this script task, and in the expression we have this seat name new, that should be equals to, if it is going to have the customer dash, then we want to load the data from this data flow task. Here it's very straightforward, like in the source that we have the Excel source, so we can drag and drop, and in the destination, that is OLEDB destination. So let me try to configure this Excel source and OLEDB destination. So double click on this Excel source, click on new. We can browse for the source, and here the file, so we can click on open, click on OK. Here we can see the seat names, but our seat name is coming from this seat name variable. Now go to on the columns. So everything looks good. Click on OK. We can connect. Double click on this. Click on new connection. So we have already made this connection. So let me utilize that. And on which table we want to load the data? So we want to load the data on the customer table. So here we have this customer table. Now we can check the mapping. So mapping succeed. Click on OK. So here we have done for the customer side. Now we need to check for the address side. So on the address side, this should be address. As I told you, first we need to load the data on the country table. So this data flow task will be going to load the data into country table. Let me double click on this. So before going to configure this data flow task, let me double click on this precedence constant. And again, in the evaluation operation, it should be expression and constant. We can click on these three dots and go to on the seat name new. This time we are going to check if we'll be going to see address dash. Then we want to load the data. So it looks good. Click on OK. Everything is fine. Now let me try to configure this address country table. So again, our source is Excel source, and our destination, that should be OLEDB destination. But in between, we need to validate whether data is already available or not. If data is not available in the destination table, only then we want to load the data. So for that, we need to use the lookup transformation. So let me configure the Excel source first. Double click on this. So it is going to use the same Excel file. Here we can see we are having the seat name, which is address. So this time let me try to make the change on the variable side. So go to on the variable, and this time I am going to put default value as address. Now double click on this address, double click on this Excel source, and we have the table name in the variable, and variable name is the seat name. Go to the columns. So we have all these columns, that is okay. But here we don't want to get all these columns. We are very excited to have only the country name. So here we'll be going to get the duplicate country names, but we don't want to see the duplicate country names. So for that we can use the sort transformation. So we can drag and drop the sort transformation to remove the duplicate from the Excel source. Double click on this, we can select that, and here we can see remove rows with the duplicate sort value. Click on OK. Let me connect this with the lookup transformation. Now double click on this lookup transformation. So here we have the cache option. So full cache is OK, and our connection type is the OLEDB connection, that is also OK. Go to on the connection. Now here from which table we want to do the lookup, that is our country table, and on which column, that is the country name column. So it looks good, everything is okay. Now go to on the general. So here we can see the specify how to handle rows with the no match entries. So here we can ignore the failure if we will not have any entries in the no match output. Now click on OK. Here we can connect only the no match output data. So if data is already available in the destination, then we can ignore those. If data is not available, then we want to load that data into the table. So let me double click on this OLEDB destination, and here let me select the country. Go to on the mappings. So country name is going to map with the country name, that is okay, and we can ignore for the country ID because this is the identity column, so it will be going to insert. Click on OK. So we have done with the country side. So once data is available in the country table, then we want to load the data into the address table. So we can drag and drop, and we can connect here. Let me try to rename this for the address main table. Now double click on this. So here the first thing that we need to drag and drop for the source. So our source is the Excel source. So we can drag and drop. Second, we need to get the country ID. So by using lookup transformation, we can get that. And at last, we want to load the data into OLEDB destination site. So everything looks good. Let me double click on this Excel source. And here we have the seat name in the Excel in the variable. So we can choose the second option in the data access mode, and that is seat name. Go to on the columns. So we are required to have all these columns. So click on OK. Let me connect this to the lookup transformation. Double click on this and go to on the connection. So we are okay with that connection. In the table side, we can select the country table. In the columns, we are going to match with the country name and from this we are required to have the country ID. Click on OK. And here while we are having the match output, so we need to go in the destination side. Here we can ignore the no match output, so we can ignore on that scenario. So this scenario is not going to happen anyhow, because while we are going to insert the data, those are available in the Excel sheet first, and after that we are going to use the same data for the lookup. So in the no match output will not have anything. So double click on this destination, and here we want to load the data into address table. Go to on the mapping site. So mapping got succeed, so everything looks good. Click on OK. So we have done with all these. So once we are going to execute this package, so it should be going to reflect an error. Let's try to execute and we'll see. So once I click on start, so it is saying it is reflecting an error, because if you go in the customer, default value we have set for the address. So that's why we are going to reflect an error. So here we need to do the delay validation option will be going to true. So that is going to check at the runtime. While it is going to compile, it should not be going to check with all the connections and validation. So in the Excel connection manager, we could see for the delay validation option. So we can click on true. That is okay. Now go to on the package level. In the package level, we can also set it as true. So delay validation option, that should be true. Now let me try to execute this. So once I try to execute, it has starting execution. So first is the address Australia. So second is the address Canada, then address others, address US, like that. So here you need to check, we are having this single quote before this name. So that's the reason, that's why we are not going to see anything on the data flow task. So let me try to stop this package. And here, double click on this precedence constant. And here, we need to go back to here and specify one single quote. Click on OK. Similarly, we need to do for the address as well. Now click on OK. Now we can start execution. So first for the address Australia. So it has start execution. So it has inserted the data into the country table. Then it is start inserting the data into the main table. Second for the Canada. Again, it is going to do the same thing. First inserting the data into the country table. Second in the main table. Next for the others. Now for US, now it is going to start with the customer Australia. So it got failed. So we need to check why it got failed. So we can go on the downside. So it is reflecting the same error that I was talking about. So click, go back to here on the customer side. So here we can see the delay validation option. Let me try to do that. We can save this. And now in the table side, we should have the data into the address tables. But in the country table, we don't see any data. So go back to the package and we'll try to evaluate. So first, let me try to use execute SQL task to truncate all these three tables. And let me double click on this. And here, let me add the same connection. And in this statement, let me try to write the statement. So truncate table. And first, it should be for the address. Second for the country. And last for the customer. Copy that, go back to the package, and here in the SQL statement, paste that. Click on OK, again OK. So as we have seen, we did not have the data in the country table. So go to on this address country, and here go to on the lookup transformation. So here, like I have made this mistake, so specify how to handle rows with the no match entries. So here we want to move the data which is no match entries in the no match output. So now it will be going to load the data in the country table. And as we seen, this data flow task for the customer got failed because here we need to use the delay validation is true for this, and delay validation should be true for this for each loop container as well. And on this level also we need to check this as true. So the delay validation that we need to set on the package level, on the task level, and on the data flow level. So that we need to set out. So I have set all these. So let me try to execute this package and we'll see what will be going to happen. So first it is going to load the data for the Australia. So it is inside the address country table, then inside the address main for the Canada. For the others, for the US. Now this would be for the customer, for the Canada, for the others, and last for the US. So all these data should be loaded in the tables. Now package executed successfully. Let me stop this package and go to on the SSMS, and here let me try to execute this select statement. So in the address table that we could see, we are having all this, and in the country table we are having all the countries, and in the customer table we are also having all the customer entries. So I hope guys you have understand how you can design this package, and if you still have any doubt, then you can drop your questions on the comment box. I will try to respond on your questions. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you really like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. See you in the next video.